Hello. Starting to Alan Wake. Probably the third or fourth time I've played this game, but I've never played the remastered version.
Stephen King once wrote that nightmares exist outside of logic, and there's little fun to be had in explanations. They're antithetical to the poetry of fear. In a horror story, the victim keeps asking why, but there can be no explanation, and there shouldn't be one. The unanswered mystery is what stays with us the longest, and it's what we'll remember in the end. My name is Alan Wake. I'm a writer. I've always had a vivid imagination, but this dream unsettled me. It was wild and dark and weird, even by my standards. So yes, it began with a dream. Following a typical nightmare pattern, I was late, desperately trying to reach my destination, a lighthouse. For some urgent reason, I couldn't remember. I'd been driving too fast down a coastal road to get there. I'd seen the hitchhiker too late. He was dead. I was convinced they'd put me in jail and I would never see Alice again.
Hope we get a sequel to this soon, Remedy Games. Excuse me.
Suddenly, his body was gone. I was in shock from the crash. I could hardly stand my feet. I was certain I had just driven from this direction, but now the road was blocked. The radiator had broken when I hit the hitchhiker. The car wasn't going anywhere. I had to go to the lighthouse. I knew there was something important waiting for me there.
I got a phone call while I was streaming. Let's see here. Options. See how that looks.
The bridge had collapsed. I'd have to find another way to the lighthouse.
100. Oh God, I don't miss that in games. Oh, okay. Got a phone call with a voicemail. Interesting. Interesting. But it ain't work, and it's not affiliated with work, so I don't care. Thanks for playing. Through my foot, you gotta love that.
Recognize me, do you, Ryder? You think you're God? You think you can just make up stuff, play with people's lives and kill them? You think it adds to the drama? You're in this story now, and I'll make you suffer.
Aren't good. Not like your stories are any good. Not like they have any
artistic merit.
You're a lousy writer. Cheap thrills and
pretentious shit.
That's all you're good for. Just look at me.
Look at your work.
Oh, I wonder what that does. I don't have an iPhone, so I can't scan that. That sucks. All right. Dodge the attack. Oh, see, because I didn't. Oh no, I'm gonna die right now.
I realized that the hitchhiker was a character from the story I'd been working on.
How does it feel to die by the hands of your own creation?
Man, I don't remember this in the beginning, and I played this at least twice. Getting old. Alright, I'm looking for the 1,000 thermoses. Or thermi. Nothing's even coming after me. I miss this era in gaming. Whoa. You gonna let me out? How the fuck do I get out? Just take a flying fuck at this, or
you should go into the light. You are only safe. Well done. I have something important to tell you. It goes like this: for he did not know that beyond the lake he called home lies a deeper, darker ocean green, where waves are both wilder and more serene. To its ports I've been. To its ports I've been. Do you understand?
No.
Follow my light. I can only show you the most important thing. This way, there's no time.
You let me look for...
...taken over by the dark presence. You can't hurt him now. The darkness protects him from all harm. Only light can drive the darkness away and make him vulnerable again. Here, take the light. Turn your flashlight toward him and burn the darkness away.
Here, take this random floating gun.
Good. You've done well. Remember what I've taught you. That is all. I will give you back your dream now.
In the nightmare, a terrible darkness was taking over the world. The lighthouse was the last safe place on Earth.
Excuse me.
You made me this way, and now I'm gonna kill.
Ooh. It's gonna commit a little murdy murder. Murder, murder. Shoot, I don't know how long I've been playing. I guess I do have to watch myself on Twitch. Didn't want to, but I need to see how long I'm playing. So I know when to take little breaks so I can edit it all on the YouTubes. Damn, that's it? Oh, shit! Pay attention here. Make sure the mic's working. Test, test. Test. Okay. Not super loud, but loud enough. This game's more important than me rambling on. Talk a little bit louder. Yeah, I'll pick up the flare gun. And a bunch of flares. What's that? I can pick something up here? Nope. Okay.
You did just like...
Time for the flare gun, motherfucker. Murka. How you like them apples, boys? Well, they didn't get a trophy for just acing that many people. The lighthouse, okay. Come on, fat ass. You don't run like me. Yeah. Shit.
Just another nightmare. Everything's fine. You dozed off.
Right. Anything more than dozed off would be news for everyone.
Cheer up, handsome. We're here.
Handsome. Oh, thank you.
Welcome to Bright Falls. Falls.
Ooh, it's got to be a thermos here somewhere.
Let's act like we're on vacation. Go stand next to that old gentleman there. I want a shot of you with the town in the background.
Sure. I'll even give you a title for the shot. A city boy, moments before he got eaten by a bear. Hi.
Hey. Hello there. You picked a good time to visit our town. Deerfest is just 2 weeks away.
Deerfest, huh? Did you hear that, honey?
Fuck is Deerfest?
You have a lovely wife. If you don't mind me saying, I'm Pat Bain, by the way. Nice to meet you.
Yeah, right, shake his hand.
Alan Wake. I won't pretend I don't recognize a famous writer such as yourself, Mr. Wake. A pleasure. I'm an avid reader myself. I hope this isn't too presumptuous of me, but I'm the night host at the local radio station. Any chance I can get an interview?
Look, Mr. Main, I'm on vacation. In fact, I'd appreciate it if we could keep my being here just between the two of us. I'm sure you understand.
Fair enough. You can trust me to be discreet. Not a hard man to track down if you change your mind, though. I hope you two have a lovely holiday.
Very nice.
Thermos.
A really good ones.
Thermos. You took like 40 pictures, lady.
Right. Yeah?
Hey, bestseller. How's my favorite writer? Are you there yet?
Barry. Yeah. We just got him.
Are the locals giving you trouble? Just say the word and I'll hop on a plane and come make sure that you're left alone, Al.
No, Barry. We're fine.
Great. Great. Just want to make sure you can relax and recharge. So,
whoa.
Has it gotten your
oh, probably a hunter.
Going?
Barry. Just settling in.
Okay, Al. I'll call back later.
Sorry, that pickup truck got me freaked, but then I saw the hunting rifles.
Okay. Okay. Just looking out for you, buddy. Talk to you later.
I love you too, Barry.
Oh. If you got a problem, yo, I solve it.
Barry is Barry. I can always turn off the phone.
What did I tell you?
Text message from Barry. He says hi to you too.
Alan, we're here. Come on, let's get back to the car.
Is this my car? Okay, like this is my car? I think this is my car.
We need to stop at the local diner to get the cabin key from the landlord. A Mr. Carl Stuckey. He's waiting for us. I'll go fill her up while you get the key. I'll pick you up here in, say, 15 minutes?
Sure.
Alan, thank you for coming here with me.
I love you too. Go on. I'll promise to behave. I'd forgotten there were still places like this. Towns where everybody knew everybody.
Welcome to the Odeer Diner.
Hi, I was wondering if you could help me. I'm looking for...
Mr. Wake. Alan, Wake. Oh, God! I am your biggest fan. I know people say that all the time, but I really am.
I'm glad to hear that.
Rose.
Rose, I'm looking for Mr. Stuckey. Carl Stuckey?
Carl? Of course, Mr. Wake.
Carl!
He wants to visit the restroom. He'll be back in a moment. I can't believe it. I've got all of your books.
Oh, there's a thermos.
From the bookstore, when they took it out of the window.
Ah, I gotta get to my thermos.
Well, okay. Good for you.
Right. So much for a quiet vacation.
Try the coffee. Just don't blame me when you fall in love.
Okay, Casey Kasem.
Do me a favor, Sonny. I could really use a tune right now. Coconut. Number 6 in the jukebox. I'd do it myself, but both of my legs have gone to sleep.
Thank you.
Bad circulation. Yeah.
Are you serious? Coconut again? You disgust me. Call yourself a rocker. Unbelievable.
It does that. Get stuck. Yeah. You need to give it a good solid whack. You put the lime in the coconut, drink them both up. Now that's what I'm talking about, yes!
This is it. I've died and gone to hell.
Don't go in there, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark.
I think I can handle it, ma'am. I didn't want to wait. I wanted to find Stuckey, to get the key and get out as soon as possible. The waitress was giving me a headache. Overeager fans always did.
Taking a shit?
Hello? Mr. Stuckey?
Fart twice if you hear me.
Carl couldn't make it. Unfortunately, he was taken ill. But I have the key for you and instructions on how to get to the lake.
Okay.
I wish you a good stay in my cabin. I'll come by later to check how you've settled in. And to meet your wife. I insist.
This game does look a ton better. Like, I'm not gonna lie. Wait, why were you?
Is a special place.
Why are you in the men's shitter? What the hell? Oh. I sell propane and propane accessories.
You hurt yourself in the dark. This really ought to be fixed.
Even that sounds better than your singing.
Are you all right?
Splendid, splendid! Damn hernia. It swells up like a balloon if I lift anything heavier than a spoon. Yeah, splendid, splendid. It's been a long time. Good to see you.
Hey, you wouldn't happen to have a bottle.
I wish.
The Andersons, they're local musicians. We're waiting for Dr. Hartman to come pick them up. They wandered off from his clinic at the Cauldron Lake Lodge. I'll be heading back to work as soon as Dr. Hartman gets here, Rose. Oh, but I'm not looking forward to the poison we have at the Park Cafe.
Bye, Mr. Wake.
Mission accomplished. The key and the directions.
My hero. I got some flashlights, just in case.
Hey, wait! Mrs. Wake! Your keys!
That diner was a real nut house.
Can you believe this place?
Ooh.
This would make a wonderful setting for a book.
We're supposed to be on vacation, Alice.
Sorry, I paint through my arm.
When we get back home, okay?
Okay. We can talk about this later.
Batman here on PBFF.
I didn't want to talk about it. I wanted to bury my head in sand.
Here's another one of my favorites to go with it.
Once upon a time, I was a successful writer, but that was a long time ago. I hadn't been able to write a word in 2 years. Not since my last book.
Happens.
Now the weather. It's gonna be a clear night, so you folks in the big city might want to look up every once in a while, see those stars winking down at you. It gets pretty dark out here, but they'll light your way.
Yeah, it's Roy Orbison.